Dear students, today we are going to discuss about the braking methods used for DC motor. Basically, when we talk about the braking, there are two kinds of braking. Here braking does not, we don't want to brake anything, or we don't, do not want to separate things. Here braking means we want to stop the motor. That belongs to braking of DC motor. There are two ways of braking. One is mechanical, another is electrical. In the case of mechanical braking, what we do, we may provide brushes and brake shoes. What we say? Brake shoes we provide on the shaft. So when we when these brake shoes will come in contact with the shaft of any motor, definitely it will stop the motor after a particular time. But you know, there are lot of tear and wears in the case of mechanical braking, and definitely heat is produced on the shaft. That may affect the efficiency or performance of DC motor. So we talk about, we are going about the electrical braking. Electrical braking means by varying the parameters or by operating the electrical parameters, if the speed of motor is reduced or motor is stopped that is called as electrical braking. There are three ways. For electrical braking, we use three methods. First is plugging, another is rheostatic braking or dynamic braking, and another one is regenerative braking. And we will discuss them one by one. So let's begin with the plugging. We will reverse the connections of armature winding, so that once the current supply is changed in the armature winding, definitely the torque produced in the motor armature will be of opposite direction, and that will oppose the general rotation of DC motor, so it will stop. So it can be understood like that. This is our DC series motor. And these are the DC supply, positive and negative. If we want to go for plugging, then what we will do? Now look at this diagram. Here, double F was connected to A, and in the another approach, now double F is connected to double A. That means the positive supply is now first connected to the brush double A, and negative supply is connected to A. So as the current direction is changed in the armature, definitely torque direction is also changed. So that, for example, if it is rotating in clockwise direction, this torque, due to the reversing of flow of current in the armature, definitely the direction of torque will be reversed, and that will oppose the actual motion, so that motor will stop. In the case of shunt motor, or for simplicity, we might draw diagram in this way. So the terminals connections of armature are reversed in the case of plugging. So that will be useful for stopping a motor. Okay. Now this belongs to plugging. Now we are discussing rheostatic or dynamic braking. In the case of rheostatic or dynamic braking, what we do, if motor is running at particular speed, we brake the terminals or we remove its armature terminals from the supply mains and then connect them across a resistor, so that the energy that is attached to the armature when it is running at its rated speed, the total energy now used in the to supply the resistance. Okay, and we can express it as okay, this is case of DC series motor. The motor is running at rated speed. Suddenly we disconnect this part of the DC motor from the supply mains, or we remove the motor from the supply mains and connected it across the resistor, like supply terminals. Now we remove the motor from supply mains and connect it across a resistor. So the power that is attached with the DC series motor will be used to supply this resistive load. And after that particular time, when the whole energy is given to this resistor, this motor will stop automatically. Similarly, in the case of DC shunt motor. Now here the armature part is removed from the supply mains and that is connected across the resistance. So its energy is given to the energy or power within the armature is given to the external resistance. So motor will stop after particular time. Third one is regenerative braking. In the case of regenerative braking, what we do? We run the motor above its rated speed. So that definitely back EMF becomes greater than terminal voltage. And in that condition, now the motor's armature acts as generator and it try to give the supply. In this condition, now armature starts supplying the power to the from the armature to the supply mains. So in that view, the direction of current in the armature gets reversed. So the direction of torque is also reversed, and that will stop the motor after some time. Okay. But this method cannot be used for because when if you look at the series motor diagram, this is a series motor. In this condition, if the EB is greater than V, then definitely current direction is changed. With that, the magnetic field quality also changed, and that will strengthen the armature. So voltage will start rising, and it will not stop the motor. Because in the case of shunt motor, when EB equals to V, motor stops. Generally, EB is less than V. When we run the motor above rated speed, EB becomes greater than V and it starts supplying to the supply mains, and it happens till EB equals to V, and in that condition motor stops. But it cannot be used for DC series motor, as I told you. When the armature starts supplying the supply mains, since the field winding is connected in series with the armature, so it also gets strengthened, and it starts increasing the voltage continuously. EB continuously starts increasing. We cannot achieve this value. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about the starting of DC motor. As we know that the armature winding of DC motor having very less resistance, and the field winding of a DC shunt motor having high resistance. So if we directly apply the 220 volt or rated voltage to the DC motor, like for example, we are applying 220 volt supply to a DC motor. whose armature resistance is 2 ohm, for we are assuming, and field resistance is 200 ohm, then in this condition the current in the armature could be 220 divided by 2 ampere, that is equals to 110 ampere, and ISS would be 220 divided by 200, that is equals to 1.1 ampere. Okay, so look at the starting, when we are switching on the supply, what we are observing, that very high amount of current flowing through the armature winding, that is much greater than its rated value of current. So in that condition, armature winding may get damaged. So to avoid that condition, we use the starters, or we use the different starting techniques. So what we can do? We can do another thing, that we may insert one variable resistor whose cap at maximum position at starting, and then slightly we are removing the resistance from the network wall. We are moving the resistance from maximum value to minimum value. So starting, in the starting, current is controlled by this series resistors, because most of the voltage drop will occur across this variable resistor. Okay, but you know, this is a manual part. We have to smoothly move the resistor. Or it could be placed here. Better we should place it so you know it is quite difficult task, that at the starting every time we have to manually move the rheostat from maximum value to minimum value, to so that the current that is flowing through the armature should be remain in a controlled value. So for that purpose we are using starters. There are two kind of starters. One, first is 3-point starter, another is 4-point starter, and we will discuss them one by one. Starter. Okay. Now this is a general diagram for representing the working of a three-point starter. Now look at it. We compare the things. This is a supply input supply. This is the input supply. Here what we are providing? We are providing external resistance who is placed at maximum value at the starting end. Then manually we are moving it in this direction. Control limit the current value. Look at here. Again, this value, similarly this value is the value current flows from this part to handle, and when handle comes in this contact with this part, this is its maximum resistance and this is its minimum resistance value. This is its minimum resistance value. So manually when we start moving this handle, then gradually resistance goes decreasing, and when it reaches its minimum value at the starting, when this push resistance is in series with these two circuits, so less amount of current is flowing through armature as well as field winding. So when it reaches to this value, this particular resistance is comes out from the network. Now that this direct supply is sending to the armature as well as field winding. Now we are having two different arrangements here. One is holdover coil, another is overcurrent protection coil. Okay, look at it. When we are moving here, what will happen? Due to the flow of current, this coil will get energized. So it will act as magnet, and when this soft electrode comes in contact with this part, like this soft electrode piece will attract to this one. Okay, so till that, when the motor is getting supply, this coil will get energized and it will acting as a magnet, so it will hold. It will hold the this arm till the motor is properly working. There is no abnormal condition, and all we want to maintain the supply continuously. If there are two different cases, first we will talk about the overcurrent. By any reason, if motor draws excess current that beyond to its rated limit, then what will happen? If it is taking excess current that is not accepted by the its rated value, then what due to the excess flow of current, this coil will get energized and this will uplift this plunger. When this plunger is uplifted, this part will get short circuited. This part will get short circuited, and this due to that short circuit, this coil will get de-energized. Once it's de-energized, immediately it will release the handle, and this handle will come to this position, and motor will start. Now motor will stop immediately. Okay. So there are two things. One is holding coil that is used to hold the handle. And second is the overcurrent protection coil. If there is if motor is drawing excess current above its rated value, that may harm the motor. In that condition, that due to that excess value of current, this coil will get energized and it will lift the plunger. So that what will happen? This part will get short circuit, and this coil is short circuit. This holder coil, so it will immediately its magnetic effect will be neutralized and it will release the handle. So motor will stop working. Okay, this is all about three-point starter. Now we talk about the four-point starter. Now look at this diagram. This is four point structure. Here we are measuring four points. First point, second point, third point, and fourth point. That's what is called is four point structure. What is the change between the three point structure and four point structure is that here we are using one metallic arm. Because in the previous section we are getting the field winding supply through this part. So what was happening? The value of current was changing. As the value of current, the value of current is changing in the field winding, same as the as in the case of armature. But here what we are making, here we did one simple arrangement is that now we provide resistance to this circuit only. Look at it. Once the handle is in this position, since it is a metal part, it starts giving supply to the field winding. Okay, so that and when we are moving this handle or arm, only the field winding, so armature winding is getting affected. So due to this part, this is the feature of four-point starter. This belongs to. And this is generally used for series motor as well as cumulative compound. So if we represent it by cumulative compound motor, it should be this is generally used for cumulative compound motors. Okay, so this the working is same, the function of coils are same, only one change is that we are providing metallic arm and one resistance is also provided in the network, and it is used for cumulative compound or compound generators. Okay, that's all about the starter or starting of DC motor as well as braking of DC motor.